Hello and welcome to another episode of Differential Calculus with Sir R Squared. In this video, we're going to discuss part 3 of derivatives of trigonometric function. We are referencing calculus with analytic geometry by Thurman Peterson. Again, we do not include the disclaimer and the learning objectives for this video because this is just a continuation of the very first video for the derivatives of trigonometric function. Nevertheless, I kept this slide for our reference kung sakaling kailanganin ng estudyanteng balikan kung ano yung mga formulas for differentiation for trigonometric functions, meron tayong readily na makikita sa video ito. We have example number 7, differentiate y is equal to cosecant x cotangent x. In this case, we are going to use the product rule. Ang sabi po sa atin sa product rule, sulat natin dito, product rule. To get the derivative, first you have to copy kung ito po daw yung inside natin, inside, at ito yung outside. Ang sabi po natin, inside times the derivative of the outside plus the outside times the derivative of the inside. So, yan po yung ating susundan na pattern. Lagyan po natin ng clouds para meron tayong susundan, ano? You can have this style or you can have the direct substitution style, whatever it is. Ngayon, ganito po ang ating gagawin. Y prime is equal to yung cosecant x. Yun po yung inside. So, we are going to copy that. Cosecant x. Ito po yun, inside. Times the derivative of the outside. The derivative of cotangent x is negative cosecant squared x. So, direct substitution, negative cosecant squared x lang po. Yan po yung derivative nung outside. Plus, o nandito na po tayo sa plus, ano? Plus, the outside, what is outside? Cotangent x. Cotangent x times the derivative of the inside. The derivative of cosecant x is equal to negative cosecant x cotangent x. Okay. So, let us try to expand. Y prime is equal to negative cosecant cube x plus or minus pala kasi negative yon. So, we will have minus cosecant x and then cotangent squared x. Dito po nang galing yan pag pinag-multiply na. Ngayon, may common factor po tayo na cosecant. So, ang gagawin po natin, ilalabas po natin yung cosecant na yan. So, y prime is equal to negative cosecant x times the quantity. So, this will become positive na po ito. Cosecant squared x, wala na po dito, minus. Or that will be plus kasi may negative yung nilabas natin. Plus cotangent squared of x. So, ito po yung ating magiging final answer. Okay, we have another example, example number 8. Y is equal to sine squared x over cosine squared x. Kung gagamitan po natin ito ng quotient rule po agad, medyo masalimuot, ano? Kasi sa baba nun, magkakaroon tayo ng d squared, edi magiging cosine to the fourth na po ito, ano? Let us try to have a trigonometric manipulation muna bago po natin na i-apply yung derivative. Okay. So, we can rewrite this y as sine sine of x quantity squared over cosine of x quantity squared. Yan. And from another identity, pwede po natin itong sabihin or algebraic property, pwede natin po nating sabihin na sine x over cosine x quantity squared. But what is sine over cosine? That is simply tangent. Y is equal to tangent x quantity squared. Yan. Ngayon, kitang-kita na po natin na pwede na natin i-apply dito. Napakasimple na kung i-apply natin yung derivative. Mag-chain rule lang po tayo dyan. Ang sabi ng chain rule? Chain rule. We have the outside. Derivative of the outside. Copy the inside. Copy the inside. And then multiplied by the derivative of the inside. Yan po ang chain rule. So, lagyan po natin ang clouds. Derivative of the outside, copy the inside, times the derivative of the inside. Gawin po natin para mas madali. Derivative of the outside, itong tungto, lilipat doon. So, y prime is equal to 2, copy the inside, tangent of x. So, 1 na lang po ito. Times the derivative of the inside, the derivative of tangent x with respect to x is equal to secant squared x. Du dx, 1 lang po yan. So, times 1, no? X lang po yan, kaya 1. So, therefore, y prime is equal to 2 secant squared x times tangent of x. And that will be our answer. So, tanggalin lang po natin tong isang to at nagmumukhang double prime. Yan. So, ganyan lang po basically. Ano? Ganyan lang po kasimple yung ating mga ginagawa dito sa trigonometric functions. Walang pinag-iwan sa algebraic. Medyo nagmumukha lang mahirap kasi trigonometric po yung mga terms, no? Pero kung ganito pong style ang gagawin mo, parang derivative of the outside, copy the inside, para ka lang din nagsasubstitute kung napapansin mo, no? So, tingin lamang po mahirap dahil may mga tangent, may second squared. But basically, they are just the same with the algebraic functions, katulad po nung 8 examples na po na atin pong naibigay. Siguro po sapat na po ang isa pang halimbawa ay sapat na para makover po natin itong ating trigonometric functions. Dahil meron na po tayong quotient, meron na po tayong direct substitution, meron na po tayong product rule, meron na rin po tayong sum. So, I think one last example will be sufficient enough to cover all the things that you need to know in dealing with derivatives of trigonometric function. That will be on the next slide. Problem number 9, we have differentiate y is equal to cosine 2x minus 2 sine x. We say y prime is equal to the derivative of cosine is negative sine u, which is sine 2x. Du dx will be 2 minus 2. Derivative of sine is cosine u, which is x times 1. Therefore, y prime is equal to negative 2 sine of 2x. Minus 2 cosine of x. This will be equal to y prime is equal to factor out negative 2. We will have sine of 2x plus cosine of x. Okay. Okay, this will be our final answer. Or if you want, you can expand this one by this identity. May identity po kasi tayong ganito, double angle formula. But we're just asked to find the derivative, so this will be fair enough. Negative 2 times the quantity sine 2x plus cosine of x. At sa wakas ng lahat ng bagay, tayo po'y magpasalamat sa Panginoon Diyos sa pagbibigay sa atin ng lakas at buhay upang mapag-aralan at matutunan ang mga bagay nito. Ang lahat ng parangal at papuri ay sa iyo, Diyos amang makapangyarihan sa lahat na nagahari noon, ngayon at magpakailanman. Magpasawalang hanggan. Amen. To God be the glory.